Hello and welcome everyone. Welcome to my first video on JavaScript, and here we are talking about the basic module where we are going to cover the basic JavaScript like variable declarations, the loop, do while loop, for in, for each, for of loop. So in the first module we are covering all of the basic aspects. So in the first module, first section, we are covering about the data types, about the operators, about the loop, about the conditionals. Okay, so first let's talk about the type declaration, types in JavaScript. Okay, so this is always an important aspect, that how we can declare the types in JavaScript. So in JavaScript, the thing is, I will be covering the things parallelly about ES5, ES6 or ES7. So JavaScript is actually evolving day by day, and what is happening, every quarterly we are getting the changes. So every yearly now there is a release of, currently we are, whatever we are writing in our browser or whatever we are compiling, that is ES5, that is known as ECMAScript also, ECMAScript 5, or you can call it as ES 2015, and yearly they will be releasing the new version of JavaScript. So now our browsers would be supporting ES 2015, which is known as ES6 also. 2015 is attached with the year, right? On, I'm not aware about it, but ES6 is the version which they are actually propagating, so that all the other browsers should support it. Now other versions which are coming on the way is ES 2016 17, that is being known as ES6 or ES7. ES7 or ES8, these are the versions. Okay, so the new changes will be coming on the way, so you don't need to worry about it. You need to worry about right now is about ES5 and ES6. ES6 is the future version and ES5 is the current version which browser is compiling on the fly. Okay, so we may be talking about the ES6 version of JavaScript in the next further videos, where we will talk about what are the new things which has come in the JavaScript world, and that's why JavaScript is now more popular, because it is giving us a lot of new advantage of using the new features like class declarations and many more. Okay, so here our first target is to cover ES5. First we will cover ES5, that is the current JavaScript version. Then we will slowly move to the ES6 or ES7. Okay, so let's talk about the variable declaration. So how we do the variable declaration in JavaScript? First of all, what all different kind of variables we have. So consider we declare var x equal to, what can be the type of x? Right now it's unknown. Right now the type of JavaScript is unknown, this particular variable is unknown. Now what I can do, I can just declare x equal to 10. What I can do, I can declare x equal to some boolean, I can declare x equal to some string. Okay, so this is the thing, x here is undefined, and here x got the value 10, maybe 10, maybe true, maybe hello. So the types which exist in JavaScript are number, boolean and string, and you can call the high level types are objects, function and symbol, which is added in ES6. Okay, and there is a type undefined also, and another is object. These are actually the types which exist in JavaScript. So whenever I do type of x, if x is 10, what I will get? I will get number. So you can see we are doing this. So type of x is number. Now if I assign type x equal to some hello, then type of x will be string. If you assign type of x equal to some object, then type of x will be object, and x may be representing some function also. Type of x is function. So all these are actually the type variations which we know, okay? And the important thing which you have seen here is after declaration you can assign the type any type. So here we haven't explicitly said that x is going to be of type boolean, string, number. It is decided based on what value you are assigning. So now I assign 10, now the type is number. Further I can assign, and I can override this value to some hello. Now the type is string. So JavaScript is not providing the type checks which we are seeing in other Java language or any other object oriented language. It's floating. Once you define x, it's undefined. Now you can assign it to the number, you can assign it to the string, or you can assign it to some object, function, boolean, whatever it is. Okay, so this is how we define the types, and the types which are like, if you do type of x, what you will get? You will get undefined because x is not defined yet. So type of x is, okay, it was like earlier declaration, whatever we had, that's why it is showing function undefined, right? So if you do type of undefined, what you will get? Type of undefined is undefined, and type of null always represent an object. Why? Because null is being presented only for the objects. So if you do var x, right now it is undefined. Now x is representing, I assign some object, we will talk about what are the object. So I assign some object to the x, so now it is representing object. X can be a null also. X can be, you can explicitly assign undefined also to the x. Okay, so these are different types: undefined, null, object, function, string, boolean, number. And after defining some variable, you can assign a particular type to that variable. You can just do whatever we have done here, like var gen, it's undefined. Now if I do type of gen, it will give me undefined. Now if you do type of undefined, it will give me undefined. But type of null will always give us an object, and undefined and null both are not same. That you should understand. Okay, similarly we can assign some variables with the boolean, we can assign some variable with the number, all the floating numbers. Okay, and JavaScript is providing a way to convert one type into another type if they are compatible, otherwise it will be any n, not a number. Okay, consider this case where I'm just declaring assign z equal to some number. Okay, now you can still assign, you can override the value to the z, right? So z is now representing hello. Similarly, z can be assigned some boolean also. That is true, right? It is it keeps overriding the values. Once you declare, you can override the values. So that's why JavaScript is static typing. It is not maintaining the type. Consider a scenario. Here z was a number, right? In idle case, you should be allowed to assign only the number that you are assigning string, you are assigning a boolean, and it is allowing it. There is no constraint over it, right? So this is how we do the declaration and the assignment of JavaScript variables. JavaScript is not a static typing. You can, these are just like floating type, you can assign any number. Okay, so in the next video we will talk about more on JavaScript variables and data types, and like conditional statements we will talk about.